Welcome back to the Time Capsule Show podcast, where we learn a little more about life through the stories of everyday people just like you and me. I'm Joerenz, and today we have a sales expert and author hailing from Berlin, Erez Agan. Welcome, Erez.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
We're so happy to have you. All right, so can you tell us a little, I find your background is really interesting. Can you tell us a little more about what you do, about your book, and how you, the journey that led you to being where you are today?
Absolutely. So I was born in Israel. Ever since I was a kid, I always thought about immigration. I was very, very curious. I always wondered what it's like to live elsewhere, meet new people, experience new cultures. And this was always in the back of my mind. And I remember that I was always curious about what it's like. And then, as I grew up, I started to travel into more and more destinations. I've been to so many destinations until I reached a certain point. And then I decided to immigrate myself. Now, when you think about immigration, you immediately think about the US, the US, Canada, maybe even Australia. Those countries were very, very popular countries in terms of immigration. But our world is changing, obviously. More and more people are coming to Europe for various reasons. And then I started to read more about immigration. And then I chose to immigrate to Germany. So why Germany? So the reasons why I chose to immigrate to Germany, I had four main reasons. One, strong economy and a low crime rate. Germany has the strongest economy in Europe, and it provides long-term benefits and also combines a social economy with a capitalistic one.
For sure, and it's always good.
Yeah, I mean, of course, I see a lot of Americans and Canadians, they really, really like to experience the social economy model. Usually, all they know is the 100% capitalistic one. So for them, it's a huge difference. And also, Germany is ranked as a country with a low crime rate. It feels pretty safe to walk around the streets. The second reason is actually a low cost of living and apartment rent. While other major cities such as London, New York,
for sure,
have a very high cost of living, Berlin's cost of living it's pretty low, even though nowadays it's getting more and more capitalistic. But it's we're talking about reasonable prices here, unlike other major cities. And the third reason was my desire to study a new language. A lot of people find it to be a burden, but for me, it was a really exciting challenge. I've never drawn back from this challenge. In fact, I was intrigued by that. I had a desire to study a new language, and I've done it with fun, with love, and I enjoyed the process as well. And the fourth reason is a very, very interesting reason is my possession of an Israeli passport, and I'll explain. After I've been doing my research, I found out that Germany allows Israelis to search for job opportunities within its borders without requiring a specific visa to do so.
Oh, wow.
So it means that if you come to Germany and you find a job, you can start the bureaucratic procedure from within without leaving the country. Now, get this. You as an American can do it as well. So Germany has this list of privileged countries. We're talking about Israel, Korea, South Korea, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, the US, Japan. So every citizen in those countries can come to Germany, find a job, and once he finds a job, he can stay. That's it. I'm not saying it's going to be easy. This is why I wrote the book, but it's a very, very interesting fact. And those were the main reasons I chose to live in Germany.
Wow, especially that last point. That, I never knew that. I wish I had learned that before. Maybe I would have
tried to
Germany.
I know. A lot of people don't know. That's why I wrote the book, because there are lots of hidden facts that everybody should know if their dream is immigration.
And so this book came from you having gone on this entire journey, like moving into Germany and all that.
Exactly. So in the book, I describe my journey as I arrived with Germany with absolutely no connections, only with a suitcase. I had no apartment, no work visa, no source of income. And then, you know, I tell my story and everything that happened to me ever since. And I've gained a lot of knowledge. That's why I was able to write the book, because the information is a very, very unique information. You cannot get it elsewhere, not even in immigration law's office. So that's why it's a very, very unique. And it shows everything, basically. It covers everything.
For sure. And now, so besides writing a book, you also work as a sales expert. Is this something, do you plan to write more books? Do you balance being an author and also working in sales?
Well, sales is my passion. This is what I do best. I have a lot of experience in sales, and this is what I wanted to do even before I got to Germany. I actually worked in sales before, and now I'm happy that I still work in sales and I was able to stay in that field, because this is what I like. This is what I do best. And as for writing a book, you know, this is my first book. I actually never intended to write the book, but something, you know, it was burning inside me to write the book, because the whole story was very, very emotional, and I gathered a lot of information, and I had a desire to write the book, not only to help others, because, you know, it was burning inside of me. You know, it's something that I had to do to help others to go to help others with their immigration process as well.
Yeah, that's an incredible story. And so going back to what you were talking about, sales for a second, where did you find your passion for sales? How did you figure out, like, sales is the thing I'm meant to do?
Well, I like to work with people. I like to interact with people. I like to negotiate. I like to close deals. I'm doing everything perfect. So I started to work in sales maybe in my mid 20s, and then I realized that I'm very, very good at it, and I'm closing deals. You know, it comes very natural to me. You know. Some consider be the natural ones. You know, it comes very, very easy to them. You know, like you know, entrepreneurs, for example. Some people are very, very good with money. They build businesses. They know how to work with money. So, you know, you gotta find your passion. A sculptor like to sculpt. Painter like to paint. Salesperson like to sell. So just do what you're good at, and you succeed with it. Find your passion, and this is what I believe in. And since I was good at it, I felt the satisfaction of closing a deal. And you know, I like bring revenue to a company. I like the closure procedure. And even now, you know, I watch YouTube videos about sales mentor once in a while. And it's fun. It's a nice job. And the fun part is that you work with motivated people. They encourage one another they all want to help one another and close deals. So it's fun. It's a friendly environment.
Yeah, for sure. All right. So let's say that you didn't end up pursuing sales. Let's say you went on a different career path. What do you think you would be doing, and then why would you be doing it?
Wow, that's an interesting question. I think I would choose a profession that will allow me to express myself. So either a coach, a mentor, maybe even an actor, I don't know. I mean, but any profession that will allow me to interact with people, that's for sure. Because there are so many professions out there, you know, coaches, trainers, something that can help others, something that can inspire others, something that can allow you to interact with others. That's what I would choose for sure.
Yeah, that definitely makes sense. Sort of like what you do with sales now, you're interacting with other people, then you're trying to impart hopefully a positive impact on their life. So it makes sense you'd want to be a coach or an actor or a mentor, things like that. Because those same jobs, you could, paths a little different, but you could do the same thing there.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so we're now at the segment of the show we like to call Past, Present, and Future, where we're going to explore three different periods of your life, and we're going to compare them a little bit. So how do you see yourself now, and how does this compare to the person you were 5 years ago?
Well, it's a good question. I think I've learned during my journey, you know, to appreciate the little things, the fact that you have a roof on top of your head, the fact that you have a place to sleep, the fact that you know, some people need help and you need to help them. I was able to get a better perspective about the city that I live in. I was able to get a better perspective about people, I guess. Because you gotta understand that immigration process is a life-changing experience. It's an emotional experience. Let me ask you this. Let's say that I take you right now, and let's say that now you're supposed to leave your comfort zone, and I put you elsewhere, just like that, out of the blue. You don't know the language. You don't know you don't have any connections. And now you need to use your skills and your social skills mostly, and other skills as well, to move forward and succeed in that place, you know. So I think the whole journey made me realize that you know, people are people. We all share the same interests and we all come from different backgrounds. However, people will always be people, social beings, you know?
Yeah. I'm thinking for a second about what I would do if I was put in that situation, like just getting thrown into another country and like not knowing. And I'm pretty sure I would just be panicking at first.
Yeah, and you know, that's what I thought. That's what I mentioned in the book, actually, that there is something that I call the immigration spirit. You need to have like a certain character to immigrate. Some will do it faster, and for some others it will take more time. But you know, it's like a marathon run. Some finish it in less than 3 hours. Some finish it maybe 3.5 hours, and some will finish it after 5 hours. And it's fine. We everybody will reach the finish line, you know. And of course, you know, for me it went pretty fast. But then again, I was very diligent, and I've managed to had lots of targets, small targets. So I've reached a target, then I moved to the next one, then to the next one, and then I was able to do it pretty fast.
Man, that's especially great for you. And I think that's a good way of handling it, like taking it point by point by point, instead of, because if you, when most people are thrown into a situation like that, it is so overwhelming. There's so many different things falling down on you, and you got to just focus on one task at a time.
Yes, yes, that's what it's a very rare story, because most people, when they move to another country, first they either find a job first, or either they go there to study, or maybe they have relatives there. So that's why they want to feel more secure. Okay, but I mean, always, you know, some people will, it will be easier for them to immigrate. Some people will have more benefits. Maybe some come with a European passport. Some will come from third world countries. But the thing is, nothing in the world can stand against the power of persistence and the desire to stay. That's the main the main conclusion of the book. Because, you know, it's all about you. It's all about your desires. What are your preferences? What is it that, whatever it takes, whatever that you want to do in life, you can achieve it. And you know, this is the main conclusion. And this is one of the reasons I wrote the book, so people will understand that it's achievable. You know, people have done it before, and everything is possible.
Absolutely. And so with all of that in mind, and especially keeping in mind this spirit of immigration, how do you think things are going to be for you in the next 5 years?
Well, in the next 5 years, I'll keep doing sales. I like sales. I may write a second part of the book. I'm not sure yet. But right now I'm in a stage that I have stability. I've gained stability in my immigration process. So I don't need to switch apartments all the time, or find jobs or anything like that. But right now, I'm in a stage that I'm a bit at ease. I'm relaxing, and I take it one step at a time. I enjoy the fruits, let's say this, and I'll see what happens. But I'll definitely I'm definitely intend to stay in sales. And and I'm gaining, by the way, more and more information about immigration all the time.
That's fantastic. So it's I really love this spirit, and especially that you've written it into a book so that other people can learn about it. This sort of like spirit of perseverance, of working hard, and even when you're thrown into like a terrible situation, like being thrown in a new country and you have no idea what's going on, you don't even speak the language, you still manage to persevere and really push through and shine through it all. So what would you say like are the principles that you like to live your life by? What are those sort of values that play into being an immigrant?
So the values that I like, first of all, honesty. I believe in honesty. I think that people will appreciate you if you be honest with them always, and honest with yourself, of course. So honesty is the key. I think honesty is a very high value. I think that also, emotional intelligence, if I can say it, you need to understand people. You need to know exactly what they are going through in order to approach them in the right way. I see, by the way, also in sales. So honesty, emotional intelligence, also persistence, as I mentioned before. Also, be true to yourself as well. And what else? I think being modest as well, just live, you know, in a way that not in a in a in a very materialistic way, but you know, be also you know, for example, myself, you know, I do meditation every day, so it helps me also, you know, to concentrate and you know, to live in a certain way that helps me, you know, help me not only to interact with people, but also help me to be in the best mental state that I can be. So those are the main values that I would put.
That is so great. And especially with how fast the world is moving today, with like everything going on from COVID to the crisis that we have in the Middle East and across different countries, what would you say you're grateful for in your life?
Well, I'm grateful that that I first of all, that I have the strength within me to, you know, to co-op with and you know, to be able to solve problems and you know, to beat difficulties and that I'm strong mentally, it helps me a lot. This is the number one thing. And second, I also grateful due to the fact that I know how to get along, and also I get up every morning with motivation, and since you know, I have my daily routine and I like to do you know, I really like my profession right now, I do not feel that I work, you know, I enjoy what I do. So of course, you know, I'm grateful that I like my profession and this is my passion, that I get to live my passion. And also that I have the knowledge, the life experience that I've gained in my life helped me a lot to go through my immigration process. So you got to understand that when I started my immigration process, I was in my mid-30s. Most of the people, a lot of youngsters come to Berlin in their 20s. So for them, it's much, much harder. When I came, I already gained lots of life experience. So I saw things a bit different, in a different way. So for me, that's what helped me to go through it. My knowledge in life. So I'm also grateful for my knowledge, for the knowledge I gained in my life so far.
That's great. And that's also very interesting, that last point that you brought up, because I think a lot of people who are like older, like not so, maybe not in their 20s or even their 30s, are more afraid to make moves and make changes. But that's interesting that you say that those life experiences actually give you a different perspective, might even make it easier to be able to immigrate.
Exactly. And that's exactly what you said. You know, people maybe they're a bit afraid to step out of that comfort zone. Maybe they do not tend to make a change. They leave their routine life. Maybe they already have kids. Maybe they have family. And that's why for them to make a change, you know, it's going to be almost impossible. But then again, you know, there is no perfect time, if you ask me. You got to feel it within yourself. So when somebody asks me what's the best time to immigrate, you know, you got to feel it yourself. You know, for example, when I was in my 20s, I didn't think about immigration. I mean, it always was in me, but I know I wanted to enjoy life more. I want to travel. I want to see some stuff. And then when I decided to immigrate, I was ready. I was prepared for that challenge. And then, you know, when I came to Berlin and saw those youngsters, you know, for them it was much harder because they you know, they always, you know, they started to study the German language and then it stopped. They started to went to clubs and bars and they didn't fully focus on their immigration goals. And then many of them came back to their native countries. Of course, for them, it was a nice experience. But I mean, immigration, as I write in the book, you need to work tremendously hard. And it's a very challenging process. And that's why I feel like, you know, I started the immigration process exactly when I was ready for it.
Have you ever thought about starting maybe like a YouTube series or even like a webinar, maybe even a company that helps inspire people and like sort of coaches them on maybe people who want to immigrate, but they're not sure how? I feel like you could do that. Maybe even have like a TED talk.
Yeah, maybe I will. I mean, as I mentioned, you know, right now I'm not at that stage. You know, I published my book. I'm creating more awareness for the book. You know, I go to podcasts once in a while. Maybe I'll develop it more in the future. Maybe in a year and a half, I'm not sure. But as I mentioned, you know, I'm in a stage right. I'm in a different stage right now. You know, I'm in a stage that I need to. I want to relax and then tell the story. You know, anything can happen. You know, maybe at some point I'll do lectures. Who knows? But this is the book that I want people to see. This is I wrote this one, this book to help others. So right now, this is I want to spread more awareness about the book, and I want people to know that if they intend to immigrate, it's going to be the ultimate immigration guide for them. Because, as far as I know, nobody wrote a book about immigration. People write books about how to be healthy, how to overcome fears, how to invest in real estate, how to become rich. But nobody wrote a book about how to immigrate. Think about it. People are doing it all the time. I mean, it's the topic is obscure. You know, I read a lot of information, and I must say, you know, it's not enough. You know, it was not enough. You know, you have so many books out there, and that's why in the book I wrote, people will be able not only to get the right perspective about the immigration process. It will actually shorten their immigration process dramatically.
There's really no books out there like that. And even if maybe someone's not moving to a different country, even moving to a different city or this different part of your nation, you're going to need to adjust to the culture. Like, for example, in America, I'm in New York. If I go down to the South, it's a very different culture from city life. It's like everyone has different accents, a different way of living. We might all talk English, but it's not exactly the same. And so you're right. There needs to be more books out there that focus on helping people adjust and acclimate.
Yeah. And you know, and I, by the way, I don't like much the phrases like moving to Germany or relocating to Germany. I like the phrase immigrating to Germany, and I'll tell you why. Because in the world immigration, you have much more commitment to the process. You're committed. An immigrant will leave his native country and he will stay permanently in his final destination. So when you say, "Hey, I found a job," "Hey, my wife got a job at I don't know, Boston. We're going there. How cool! All right, she got a job. After 2 years, maybe things will change. All right, you maybe it will develop to an immigration process. Maybe you'll come back. You don't know yet. All right. When you say, "Hey, I'm moving right now to I don't know to Honolulu," all right, I'm going to check that out. You're going to move there, but you're not fully committed to stay there. All right, and this is the difference. Immigration is a commitment. It's a commitment to yourself. that you will do whatever it takes, as long as it takes, but you will achieve your goal. All right? And that's the difference.
I love that, having affirmation in the words that you use. Like, you're right. Like, if you're just moving, it's like, oh, if anything goes wrong, I can come back. But when you're immigrating, like you said, it's like, I'm staying here. It's going to work out. I'm going to make it work. Doesn't matter what.
And let me tell you another thing. You know, most of the successful immigrants are coming from poor countries, third world countries, mm-hmm. because for them, there's no way of going back, you know? Yep. So they work tremendously hard. And that's why they're the most successful ones, you know? They're not spoiled.
I used to know this Albanian guy that I used to work with. He traveled all the way from Albania, and he was basically trying to make it in New York. I felt bad about myself. Like, there's so much opportunity, and I'm not doing this. He basically had no days off, was working almost 7 days a week. He was feeding his kids, and he was working so many different jobs, trying to network and do this and do that. He was working so, so hard. And I was like, I want to get that. Incredible.
Yeah.
So in your book, is there a section that's related? I know with recent events, we've had like COVID and the pandemic coming up. Is there a section or maybe an addendum about COVID and health concerns?
Yes. There is a section. And not only there is a section, I saw the benefits that Germany provided to the residents of Germany due to the COVID. So if you lost your job, since we're talking about the social economy model, I share everything there. So yes, there is.
That is amazing. All right. So now we're up to the final question of our show. And this is where we get our title from. If you were to leave something in a time capsule for people to dig up 100 years later, what would you put in there and why?
We only live once. So, never give up your dreams. Never give up your dreams, never give up your passions. You know, during my journey, I talked to a lot of immigrants and they all said the same. They said that, coming to Germany was the best decision they've made in their life. So, it definitely was the price. If you want to immigrate, it definitely worth the price. You'll have to work hard. But it's a gift for a lifetime.
That is an amazing time capsule. All right. So is there any final words that you have, anything you want to add? Maybe like where people can follow you or where people can purchase your amazing book?
Yeah. So the book is available on Amazon, all of its regions. You can also purchase the Kindle version. It's fun. It's enjoyable. It's easy to read. If you are passionate about immigration, you'll find this book very interesting. If you intend to immigrate, it's a must read. So, purchase it, enjoy it. This is the most important thing. Enjoy it. Enjoy. It's a very, very emotional book. It's like you're doing this journey together with me because it's my own memoir. It's like I write a diary. So you get to feel like you're traveling into the street of Berlin and you're doing it together with me. So you get to see the street, the alleys, the people who I've met, everything that happened to me. So when I was writing this guide, I wrote it and I wanted to, I didn't want it to be without any emotional aspect. And with this book, you get everything basically. So read it, enjoy it. Find it on Amazon, search my name on Google, see some more interviews I've conducted, enjoy it. Berlin's Immigration Secrets.
All right, great. Well, Erez, thank you so much for being a part of our time capsule. Thank you to our listeners for tuning in, and please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and make sure to check out Erez's book on Amazon and on Kindle. Tune in again next week to meet another amazing addition to our time capsule. We'll see you all next time.